But this is China's biggest outbreak in about 2 months, and there are concerns, of course, given the history of what the country has gone through, that it could spiral. They're not taking any chances.
Yeah, look, I don't think this is a huge sort of concern here. I think this reflects what China has gone through a number of times since it contained that first large outbreak in Wuhan earlier in the year. It has seen flare-ups. The virus is very insidious. And they have contained them with a playbook that has been largely successful. That means mass testing. They are testing this entire city. You know, it's quite incredible when you think there's some 200 cases here, and they're rolling out testing of some 11 million people. They also use the quarantine system, obviously, to control cases getting in, and a pretty sophisticated tracking system that uses surveillance technology, obviously, and mobile data usage. So I don't really expect this one to get out of control, though it is really interesting in that it shows how insidious this virus is, that it can still come back in these places that have closed their borders and really tried to snuff this out.
Emma, and we do have more definitive results so far when it comes to China's Sinovac vaccine. What do we know?
Right. Well, overnight, their biggest trial, this is in Brazil, which has the world's third largest outbreak, so pretty significant clinical trial location for Sinovac there. They came out saying that the shot is 78% effective against preventing COVID-19 from developing. That's pretty good and in line with what Sinopharm, a state-backed vaccine maker that already has its vaccine in general use in China, has been reporting, and along the line, so a little bit better than AstraZeneca. It's very, very far behind the mRNA experimental vaccines from Pfizer and Moderna, though, but still, you know, in the territory of efficacy and working here. So Brazil says that it will apply tomorrow for authorization of this vaccine, which Sao Paulo in particular is relying quite heavily on. We also have Indonesia next week likely to authorize the Sinovac vaccine, and potentially the president there even getting the shot on TV.